Hi, let's discuss topological sort. It is another application of decrease and concur technique. We can do topological sort in two ways. One by using DFS graph traversal, another by source removal technique. That source removal technique is an application of decrease and concur, decrease by one. And topological sort we can only do in DAG. DAG means directed acyclic graph. The graph should be directed and there should not be any cycle. A graph with direction specified for all its edges called directed graph or digraph. So for topological sort, it should be a digraph and there should not be any cycle. If we do DFS forest of a directed graph, there can be four type of edges possible. First is tree edges, back edges, forward edges and cross edges. I already discussed in DFS lecture how to create DFS forest and what is tree edges, what is back edges. If there is an edge from a vertices to its ancestor, that is called as back edges. If there is an edge from one vertices to its descendant, that is forward edges. If it is neither back edge nor forward edge, then it is a cross edge. So in a DFS forest, if some back edge present, then the graph is not a DAG, means there should not be cycle. Back edge means it is a cycle. So if we are creating DFS forest, there should not be any back edge. Or in simple way, we can say the directed graph without any cycle is called as a DAG. A topological sort of a DAG, G equals to VE, G for graph, V for vertices, E for edges, is a linear ordering of all its vertices such that for every directed edge UV, then U must appear before V in the ordering. If there is a edge UV like this, then U must appear before V. If the graph contains a cycle, then no linear ordering is possible. So for topological sort, first condition is the graph should be a DAG, directed acyclic graph. We can view a topological sort of a graph as an ordering of its vertices along a horizontal line so that all directed edges go from left to right. Let's discuss the first algorithm of topological sort, that is by using DFS. Call DFS G to compute finish time for each vertex. We'll do the DFS and we'll compute finish time for each vertex. Then second step, as each vertex is finished, insert it onto the front of the linked list. Third, return the linked list of vertices. So this is the algorithm. By using DFS, we can find the topological sort. Topological sort is also one application of DFS, depth first search. So here, what will be running time? Running time is same as depth first search. We can perform a topological sort in time theta V plus E, V for vertices, E for edges. As depth first search take theta of V plus E time and in take order of one time to insert each vertex onto the front of the linked list. So theta of V plus E for depth first search and order of one for inserting into linked list. So that's why total it is theta of V plus E. Topological sort running time is theta of vertices plus edges. So this is all about first algorithm. Let's discuss the second algorithm. The second algorithm is based on direct implementation of decrease by one and concur technique. It's also called as source removal algorithm. So repeatedly identify in a remaining digraph a source which is a vertex with no incoming edge and delete it along with the edges outgoing from it. And if there are several sources, break the type arbitrarily. The order in which the vertices are deleted yield a solution to the topological sorting problem. And another important point that the solution obtained by source removal algorithm is different from one obtained by DFS based algorithm. You may get different topological ordering by source removal algorithm and DFS based algorithm. Maximum time we get more topological ordering by using source removal algorithm. If in exam it is asking number of topological ordering possible, then use source removal algorithm, as by source removal algorithm you will get more ordering than DFS based algorithm. Both of them are correct. The topological sorting problem may have several alternative solutions. So if you are doing by DFS based algorithm or source removal algorithm, both are correct, but you may get alternative solution, you may get different solution. You will get maximum topological ordering by source removal algorithm, whereas you will get less topological ordering by DFS based algorithm. Let's discuss one example, example 1. Let's take a one directed acyclic graph. This is a directed acyclic graph. You can mark there is direction plus there is no cycle. I will find topological ordering by both DFS based algorithm and source removal algorithm. Let's first do by DFS based algorithm. We need a linked list. So let me draw a linked list. After A, I'll visit B. B discovery time will be 2. After B, I'll visit D. D discovery time will be 3. Then I'll visit E, discovery time will be 4. Then I'll visit G, discovery time will be 5. Now it's a dead end, so we'll backtrack. I'll finish it, so finishing time will be 6. So when we are finishing, we can insert it. So let me insert G here. Next, I'll backtrack, and from E, I'll check any adjacent is left. No, so I'll finish E and I'll insert E into linked list. Next, I will backtrack and check from D in adjacent left. Yes, F is left. So here discovery time will be 8. Also finishing time will be 9, as all its adjacent are visited. So I'll insert F into linked list. Next, finishing time of D will be 10. I'll insert D into linked list. Next, finishing time of B will be 11. I'll insert B into linked list. Next, from A, I'll visit C. So C discovery time will be 12. Also, it is a dead end, so we'll finish it. Finishing time will be 13. So we'll insert C into linked list. Next, we'll finish A. So A finishing time will be 14. We'll insert A into linked list. Now we got the DFS sequence A, B, D, E, G, F, C. And from this, we got the topological sequence A, C, B, D, F, E, G. There may be multiple DFS possible. Here, after A, we visited B. Suppose after A, we will visit C. Then we will get another sequence. Here, after D, we visited E. If after D, we visit F, then we will get another sequence. Let me do another DFS traversal. So for A, timing will be 1, for B, 2, for D, 3. After D, let me visit F. So 4, then G will be 5. Then here finishing time will be 6. I'll insert G into linked list. Next, for F, finishing time will be 7. So I'll insert F into linked list. Next, from D, I'll visit E. So 8 will be discovery time. 9 will be finishing time. Next, I'll insert E into linked list. Next, D finishing time will be 10. I'll insert D into linked list. Then B finishing time will be 11. I'll insert B into linked list. Then C discovery time will be 12 and finishing time will be 13, as it is the dead end. So I'll insert C into linked list. Then A finishing time will be 14. We'll insert A into linked list. Now I got another DFS sequence. After D, we visited F first, then E later. So A, B, D, F, G, E, C. For this DFS sequence, we got the topological sequence as A, C, B, D, E, F, G. So after A, we visited B. Suppose after A, first we'll visit C. Then we'll get another sequence. So it will be 1, 2, 3, now I'll finish it, 4, I'll finish it, 5, now from A we'll visit B, so it will be 6, then from B we'll visit D, so 7, will visit E. So 8 all arsene visited. So finishing time will be 9. Then we'll backtrack. And from D, we'll visit F. So here it will be 10 and it is a dead end. So we'll finish it 11. Now for D, finishing time will be 12. For B, finishing time will be 13. For A, finishing time will be 14. We got this sequence. Either when you got the finishing time, at the same time you can insert into linked list, or after doing the DFS, according to decrease order of the finishing time, you can insert. A finishing time is 14, so A will insert here. Next, B finishing time is 13, we can insert B here. Next, D finishing time is 12, you can insert D here. Next, F finishing time is 11, so you can insert F here. E finishing time is 9, so you can insert E here. Next, C finishing time is 5, so you can insert C here. Next, G finishing time is 4. So at end, we'll insert G. So either you can write according to decrease order of finishing time, or when you got a finishing time, at the same time you can insert. So now we got the sequence A, B, D, F, E, C, G. In previous DFS sequence, after D we visited E, let me visit F first. So DFS sequence will be A, C, G, B, D, F, E. Let me write time here. For A it will be 1, for C it will be 2, for G it will be 3, then 4, here 5, then B will be 6, D will be 7, F will be 8, then 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Next, we'll find topological sequence according to this DFS sequence. So we'll just write vertices according to their decreasing order of finishing time. First will be A. So after A, it will be B, 13. Then after B, it will be D, 12. Finishing time is 12. Then after D, we'll write E. Finishing time is 11. Then after that, we'll write F, finishing time is 9. Then after that, we'll write C, finishing time is 5. Next, we'll write G, finishing time is 4. So, got the sequence A, B, D, E, F, C, G. We got 4 topological ordering by DFS based algorithm. In next lecture, I will discuss source removal algorithm for same example. If you apply source removal algorithm, you may get more topological ordering than DFS based algorithm. If today's lecture is helpful for you, please like and subscribe. Thank you.